so many of us want to find meaning or do things with purpose, but we don't really always know how to do that on our own, or especially if we feel like we're the only ones that think that way.
Each youth is different. They come from like different realities, belief systems, backgrounds, just different.
I have friends in the community or people that I don't even know, but like we're all still living in the same place. We're all still concerned.
But it's about actually being with others and being with others in a way where one can talk about life, talk about the community, talk about social issues, and to be able to talk about it in a way that other friends of your same age can also talk about it and reflect with you.
It seems that in my immediate surroundings, these are some of the needs. And so I want to see how I can contribute so that a visible change and a long-term change is made. Maybe I, as an individual, can't make that change, but me working with others that have that same desire can make that permanent change.
But to do that, you need others, and you need to have friends that you can trust and rely on. And you need to be with people who welcome anything you have to offer.
It's important for them to feel empowered, to feel that they are able to help their own community transform, both materially and spiritually. There's no such thing as like, or at least I don't think there's such thing as like somebody coming into the community and saving it. It's mostly like the individuals in the community that are taking ownership of their own growth.
Right now, my service to the community is far different than what it was in middle school. Now it's a lot more of thinking about generations younger than me and thinking about how best I could serve them so that they can have a future that's a lot better and brighter than the one we have today.
Service-oriented leadership is conceived differently in the sense that like for a period of time, like you're maybe more in the forefront than others, but then like you're consciously also thinking of like who could be that other person that would lead the community and so forth. So it's like you're consciously thinking about the transition, like who could be the next like leader, building capacity in others so that others can also be leaders. But then to take ownership of their own growth, and they need to be able to draw upon like the knowledge that has been readily available, both scientific and spiritual knowledge.
On a spiritual level, I don't see my spiritual life or my spirituality as separate from these activities that I do or these different areas of my life. So I don't see that I'm a spiritual person in one area and then myself in another area. My spiritual values are what allow me to remember that you should see all work that you do as an act of service. Your work, your contribution to society is as worthy as worship itself.
I think it's really important for a community to have such like family dynamics. It helps motivate and empower youth not to like go and out and get money. That's very short-term and not very lasting, but to actually contribute something that will generate joy and happiness and unity in a community for generations to come. It's always kind of abstract, but when I found like a way to actually do service and to contribute, it made a bunch more sense, and I was able to recognize that like this is something that's good, this is something that will help and not be destructive or violent. And part of that also like helps me think of like how as a community we can persevere like bad times if we do have a more like loving relationship, if we know each other. And even when there aren't bad times, we can even like come together and build something that's better and that's like more vibrant and cohesive.
And to come into a community where they can actually develop plans and ways of serving their own community, of helping their neighborhood. But we have to start small. We have to work in neighborhoods at this point. And that can really vibrate throughout the rest of the community.
I do see every aspect of my life as one coherent whole. I believe that the world not only needs unity, but it's capable of achieving it. And if there's adults looking towards youth to take the reins once we graduate college and whatnot, Like, why not as youth look towards those slightly younger than us, like teenagers and preteens, to start thinking about their role in society and things like that?
So like these things helps us understand how like a specific community be more united. Like what are the qualities that a community needs to develop so that they can be of greater support to one another, so that we can understand like what love is, or what justice means, or what generosity means, or what cleanliness means, or purity means. And then how is that applicable to our own individual life? And then also how it's applicable to our collective lives. But if we draw upon that knowledge together, then we can learn how to implement it. I think it's important for youth to be leaders, or at least be considered to be leaders, because given the reality of the world in which we live, youth have a lot of unique characteristics within them. And like all of these different perspectives, if they are heard, then you would have leaders that are more acquainted with the reality of the world, and hence like more rooted in the reality of the communities.
And it's a great thing for a person of my age to spend time with young people like that, because you realize they are not yet cynical. And so if you help children and youth of that age grow into their own identity and give them a kind of a foundation in terms of how they express themselves, in terms of their moral identity, then that's a basis for success throughout the rest of their lives.